I'm going to add a cone to the screen. Make this a little thinner and color this chart 11. Now I'm going to add a sphere to the screen. And I'm going to make this color black. I want to combine the sphere and the cone. My first thought is to just drag it over, select them both, and group them both together. And if we move these left and right, it seems to work. But if I rotate these, we see that our cone and our sphere just don't look right. So I'm going to use Control Z and go back to our two objects. If we want to combine these shapes, we'll want to select one of the shapes. I'm selecting my sphere. I'm going to right click and we can cut or copy. I'm going to copy this. And now I'll select the shape that I want to combine this with. I'm going to right click on it and enter group. To show that we've entered the group, we see that our sphere or any other objects on that slide will look like watermarks. Now that I've entered the group of the cone, I'm going to right click and select paste. We see that our sphere is right in the center of the cone. We want this to be on the top. There are two ways we can do this. One is to just bring the sphere down. The other is to use Tab, and we can select between our two objects. So there's our ball going up. Now selecting our cone, bringing that up. I'm going to exit the group. And now it will act like a single object. When we move to the left or the right, and if we rotate it, it holds together nicely. And I should mention that this only works with 3D bodies, not with 3D shapes. And to remind us all what 3D shapes are, I'm going to select one. I'm just selecting a basic shape here. Clicking in our lower right hand corner, the extrusion on off. We don't need this toolbar. I'm going to copy just like I did before. Now I'm going to enter group and try and paste our 3D shape. And we see nothing happens. So I'm going to exit the group. And the way to tell the difference between a 3D body and a 3D shape is in this lower left-hand corner. When we have a 3D body, it says 3D scene selected. When I select my 3D shape, it says shape selected. In the LibreOffice guide online, they've got a circle with little hearts on there. I'm going to change these colors. And now I'm going to add the little hearts. They've got one up at the center. And we're going to make this one red. We're going to use chart 11 again because it's easy to find. And what the point of this is to show that just like in our 2D shapes, when we place an object on the screen, the first one placed is the one in back. The next one placed is the next layer up. And in this case, we're just going to have the two layers. But I'm going to rotate this heart down with our rotation. I'm going to bring down the rotation point right to the center. And to rotate this around, I'm grabbing one of the corners. But first, I want to use Control C, Control V, and then rotate this around. And you can make as many as you like. I am just going to make four. Control C, Control V. Rotating this around to the bottom. Control C, Control V. And one more. Now I'm going to select all of these. Control C, Control V to make one more copy. Because we're going to show the difference on how 3D shapes work with this versus 3D bodies. We're going to make this one on the right 3D shape, clicking on the extrusion on off, and it looks okay, but when we start to rotate it, it really doesn't hold together too well. So we're going to take this other one and make it a 3D body. And that's easy enough by just clicking on Convert to 3D. Now when we rotate this, we see that it stays together pretty well. And we can see that the hearts kind of stick out. Putting the hearts on top, I'm going to enter the group and bring this down. And we see that the hearts stick out a little more. I can also tab around, selecting one of the hearts. Maybe I want to change the color of this one, light magenta. And also, I can make this one a little bit bigger. I can move it around if I like. And now I'll exit the group. On this slide, I'm going to add a rectangle and insert some text. Selecting the text, I want to change the font to maybe this Arial Black. Make this a little bigger, maybe 28. And let's resize our box so that it fits it a little better. And I'm going to make this a 3D body. We see this looks very similar to what we just had. I can enter the group, selecting just the rectangle. I can take it down a little bit. I can change the scale depth. Maybe I'll make this one 80%. Let's change the material. We'll make this gold. I'm going to exit the group, because now I want to rotate this so I can see the lettering. Now I'm going to enter it again and select some of the lettering. Maybe I'll change this one to green. Selecting the O. And I'm going to change this to plastic. And it looks like I missed the eye. And again, we can select this and move it around as we like. Maybe we want this L a little bit bigger. It's off to the side. Let's bring it back. We can rotate it a little. Looks like it's kind of falling off there. And I'll exit the group. I'm going to add another rectangle. And now I'm going to add a layer of text. Instead of right in the object, I need a separate layer. Selecting that, making it again Arial Black, maybe 28. Perhaps we'll go a little larger. Let's go up to 36. I'm going to place the text right into our rectangle. And now I'm going to make the rectangle a little smaller so it fits in a little nicer. Now I'm going to select this all, modify, shapes, subtract, and I'm going to make this my 3D shape. Now it's hard to tell here if I angle it up a little bit, but also I'm going to come over and change our rounded edges from 10% and make them 0. And also I can make this a little larger. Or I can add a square and then add the ring or circle with a hole in it. I'm going to select these all, modify, shapes, subtract, make this a 3D shape. Now I'm just going to take a circle make this one a 3D shape. And let's change the color. We'll use light green. I want to make this a little thinner, 0.1. Now I'm going to cut this. I'm going to enter our square with a hole in it. Enter group. And now I want to paste this inside. It's a little small, so I'm going to tab to it and make it a little bigger. And now I'm going to exit the group.